So this is my NS panel, and I'll briefly go through the key features of how I've set it up. It's off at the moment. Tap it and it will come on. Tap it properly. You can see, hopefully, that there's a top row showing time and date and the outside temperature, and the bottom row shows porch and hall light status. The buttons I use for controlling the porch and hall lights, because that's something I do a lot. So for example, switch on the hall light and you can see hopefully it's on and the highlight is yellow, and when I switch it off, it goes off. I have four buttons on there at the moment that show status of that's a light in the living room, that's the TV, that's the boiler, and that's another page to control the thermostat. Let's go to the thermostat very briefly. Tap to that, you can see the thermostat there, and I've used typical icons. Note that the porch and hall is still there, the top row is still the same. I keep that as a constant, and I can reduce the temperature, a little bleep to tell me I've done it. Put it back up, off it goes, I can switch it off. If I have any bleeps to tell me that I've done it correctly, put it back on, and I'm going to take you back to this page. TV on, TV off. These are the MDI icons, and I've simply got background colour, and they go yellow when it's on, black when it's off. This is the boiler. Now the boiler, I don't want somebody to tap accidentally. So if you tap it, it doesn't work. There's a cookie yellow, but it doesn't work. You have to hold it for 2 seconds. Yeah, now it's on. Switch it off, same thing. You can't just switch it off by tapping it. You have to double tap it, which I just did by accident. So put it on, comes on like that. A tap doesn't stop it. I have to double tap it. There you go. Another feature of the lights, if I hold this button down for a couple of seconds, I can control the brightness and the temperature with the sliders. I think that's the main features of my panel. Hope you find it interesting.